Mabuhay! Welcome to another edition of Shot and Learn. In today's lesson, we're going to talk about Verbos Reflexivos or Reflexive Verbs. From the meaning itself, Verbos Reflexivos or Reflexive Verbs, so it indicates that the verb used by the subject reflects back or receives back by the subject. So, sa katagang Tagalog, ito yung kasabihang kung ano yung ginawa mo ay babalik sa'yo. Ngayon, unawain muna natin kung paano ba ginagamit ang mga reflexive verbs o verbos reflexivos sa Espanyol at kung kailan natin ito gagamitin. So, verb is reflexive when the subject and the object are the same. Meaning to say, the doer of the action also receives back the action. Now, let's analyze the examples. With the use of reflexive verb, for example, I wash myself. So, the subject is I. The verb is to wash. And the object or the receiver of the action is myself, which is also the subject. And for non-reflexive, I scratch the dog, the subject is I, the verb is to scratch, and the object or the receiver of the action is the dog. So, it's not the doer anymore. Now, based on these two examples, so we can identify the use of the verbs, if it is reflexive or not, given that the subject is also the receiver of the action. And if it is not, then it is not reflexive or the verb is not reflexive. Now, how do we identify if the verb is used as reflexive or not, or can be used as reflexive or not? Remember in the previous discussions, the verb is called an infinitive verb if it is on the base form. So meaning to say, if the verb in Espanol ends in AR, ER, or IR, they are called infinitives. Now for reflexive verbs, infinitive verbs with SE in the end or with SE attached to the infinitive is your reflexive verbs, or I call it the infinitive reflexive. So let's take a look at these examples of reflexive and non-reflexive forms of the verb. Lavar means to wash, which is non-reflexive, but lavarse, to wash oneself, is reflexive. Rascar, to scratch, is non-reflexive. Rascarse, to scratch oneself, is reflexive. And cepillar is to brush, non-reflexive. And cepillarse is to brush oneself, which is reflexive. Ngayon naman, kailangan alamin din natin yung mga reflexive pronoun na dapat natin gamitin kapag gagamit tayo ng reflexive verbs. So, pag sinabi natin reflexive verbs na may se sa dulo, yung se, yan ang papalitan natin ng reflexive pronouns kapag gagamitin na natin siya sa sentence. Ibig sabihin, yung verb na infinitive, i-conjugate natin katulad ng pag-conjugate natin ng verbs. At yung se ay nire-represent nitong mga reflexive pronouns na ito base sa doer ng action or kung sino ang doer at receiver ng action. So, for the reflexive pronoun me, in English, it is myself. Te, yourself or you informal. Se could be himself, herself, or yourself formal. Or it could be also themselves or yourselves formal. We also have nos for ourselves and os for yourselves informal. Now, let's try to use the reflexive verb in a sentence. So, with this instruction or rule, pronoun is placed before the conjugated verb for one verb. Meaning to say, kung gagamit tayo ng isang reflexive verb sa sentence, yung reflexive pronoun, ilalagay natin siya bago ilagay ang conjugated verb. Let's take a look at the first example. Alex takes a bath every day. So, Alex se banya cada día. In this sentence, we use the reflexive verb bañarse, which means to wash oneself. Now, if you're going to analyze the sentence, so the subject is Alex, which is in the third person. So, our reflexive verb again is bañarse. So, what we do, the verb or the infinitive verb bañar, we conjugated it into a third person, which is baña. And the reflexive pronoun for the third person is se. That's why we put se, or your reflexive pronoun, before the conjugated verb of bañar. That's why it became se baña. Let's look at the second example. I shave my face now. Yo me afeito la cara ahora. In this example, we use the reflexive verb afeitarse, which means to shave oneself. So, the subject is yo, or I, and the receiver of the action is also I, because it is my face. Okay? That's why it became reflexive. But you might be wondering why we didn't use the possessive adjective, which is me in Espanol, for my. And if you can remember to the previous lesson as well with possessive adjective, one of the rule is we do not use possessive adjectives for article of clothing or body parts. Now, if you're going to look at the reflexive verb conjugated in the first person, so we have afeito, because the doer of the action is I, or yo, and the reflexive pronoun for myself is me, and we place it before the conjugated verb of afeitar. Now, let's look at the third example, which is we wake up early every morning. Translation, nosotros nos levantamos temprano cada mañana. So, in this example, we use nos because the doer of the action is nosotros and also the receiver of the action. Next example, you informal sleep very late at night. Tú te duermes muy tarde por la noche. So, in this case, the doer of the action is you informal, and the verb that we use is dormirse. That's why we use the reflexive pronoun te. For the last example, we have Kali and Alexa sit properly. Translation, Kali y Alexa se sientan correctamente. In this case, we use the reflexive verb sentarse, which means to sit oneself. Now, let's take a look at the placement of the reflexive pronoun with sentence or sentences with two verbs. So, with this kind of sentence wherein we have two verbs, the first verb is always conjugated and the second verb remains infinitive. So, in this case, for ejemplo, Juan needs to wash his hair. So, we have two verbs which are needs and to wash. So, in Espanol, this will be now translated as Juan se necesita lavar el pelo, or Juan necesita lavarse el pelo. So, as you can see, the first verb from the verb necesitar, it is conjugated to the third person, And the second verb is your reflexive verb, which is lavarse, but it is in the infinitive form. And your reflexive pronoun is placed before the conjugated verb. So that is your first option. So the next option of placing the reflexive pronoun with two verbs is to place or attach the reflexive pronoun with your infinitive verb. So with the same example, Juan needs to wash his hair. So the second translation is Juan necesita lavarse el pelo. In this case, we attach the reflexive pronoun se to the infinitive verb lavar. So don't get confused. It so happened that the subject is in the third person. That's why we have the verb lavarse wherein the pronoun is attached. It doesn't necessarily mean that we just put the lavarse infinitive reflexive in the sentence. Another example, Maria can wash her face now. So we have two verbs, can and wash. So in Espanol, we use the verb poder, which is can, and lavarse again, which is to wash. Translation, ahora Maria se puede lavar la cara, or ahora Maria puede lavarse la cara. And for the last example, we have the verb acabar, which means to have just done something, and acostarse, which means to go to bed. English, I have just gone to bed. In Espanol, acabo de acostarme, or me acabo de acostar. Now, take note, if the verb directly follow a preposition, it remains infinitive. So what you need to do is just simply attach your reflexive pronoun to the infinitive verb. So for ejemplo, antes de dormirme, yo ruego al Dios. Before sleeping, I pray to God. Antes de dormirte, tú ruegas al Dios. Before you sleep, you pray to God. And antes de dormirse, la chica ruega al Dios. Before sleeping, the girl prays to God. Antes de dormirnos, nosotros rogamos al Dios. Before we sleep, we pray to God. Antes de dormiros, vosotros rogáis al Dios. Before you all informal sleep, you all pray to God. And antes de dormirse, los chicos ruegan al Dios. Translation, before sleeping, the boys pray to God. Okay, so I hope you learned something new today. And always remember, you will not achieve anything if you don't give it a shot. Adios! Salud!